What's up? Will File here, producer, dumbass extraordinaire. Today I'm going to talk about one of my first real placements ever, and that is the song Avenue by H.E.R.
I just turned on your avenue. I had to, but I'm mad at you, yeah. You always say I got an attitude, oh.
I think it was like around 2016, I was just kind of starting to get my career started. I had just signed publishing and like just starting to do my first sessions and working, you know, with actual artists. And I was in Jamaica for like a writing camp that they had put on for us. On the way back, someone had asked me, hey, do you want to get in with this artist? And I had not heard of H.E.R. at the time. So I asked my sister, like, oh, yo, have you heard of this artist, this and that? My sister was like, absolutely, take that session, da 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 da. And it was like one of these ones where I had to go to the studio right after I got off the plane. So I showed up with my baggage and had to put them in the corner, and I was all embarrassed. But I could just tell that like it was gonna be a good session because of how excited like everyone was. So I get in there and I just kind of start, you know, playing my chords or whatever. And she immediately starts vibing out, writing something really cool to what I was doing. So then it was kind of just off to the races. I just added a couple elements and it seemed like it happened in like 5 minutes. And I remember at the beginning of the session, H.E.R. manager was like, you know, H.E.R. EP is done. This will probably be for H.E.R. next thing. She's just writing right now. But at the end of the session, everyone liked it so much. They were like, nah, this needs to be on the EP. So I just barely made it. She ended up releasing that EP, then combining both of H.E.R. EPs for an album, and that ended up winning a Grammy. So it was kind of a crazy turn of events from me kind of doing this session that I didn't really know much about to being involved in a Grammy winning project and receiving a Grammy certificate for being involved. So pretty cool, definitely super grateful, and it's still one of my favorite songs I've been a part of. So I thought it'd be fun to pull the original session up here and go through some of the ways that I actually made it. Okay, so this whole idea, this whole beat started from this patch here, which I call Dway Chords, which is literally just a vocal sample put into a sampler. And I just started vibing on, you know, chords that I play a lot, you know, when I'm doing R&B. And it was literally like the first thing that I did, she was like, I really like that. So we went with it. And I kind of just filtered them out, made them a little bit more smooth, and then turned into this. Mixed that with this little perk loop that I made, kind of pitching some stick samples around. So as far as these drums go, I think I built the whole beat out, kind of had it coming in right away. And it was H.E.R. idea. She said, wait to bring the beat in. Kind of like, it was like halfway through verse two or something. So she had like a lot of really good production ideas and I thought that was dope. So that's what we did. I kind of wanted the snare to be a little bit left field, not just like a trap snare or something. So I combined a couple different weird samples. This one I widened with the, what is this effect called? Hans effect?
That is not correct.
I can't remember. Haas effect? Yeah, anyways. So we have this wide sample mixed with this click here. And that's grouped up with this kind of weird delay. So that kind of gives the drums a unique character there. I remember when I first got blap kits, I absolutely rinsed this loop. Shout out Illmind for that, because most usable tambourine loop of all time. Mix that with like a couple percussion elements and you've got the drums. There's really not a lot going on. It's pretty simple. Just a nice little bounce. As far as 808s go, I tend to always come back to 808 Warfare, which is this now pretty old contact library, but it's still really useful. The 808s sound good and it's really playable. So I used it back then and I still use it today. So I think I played the initial notes and then I always bounce it to audio so I have an easier time doing slides and chops and cuts and things like that. And as you can hear, I've got a lot of slides and stuff going on. And how I'm processing the 808 is something that I kind of used to do a lot that I don't do a lot anymore, whereas I kind of have a low split, a low and a high frequency split, where the low is kind of compressed and mono, whereas the high is a little bit overdriven and widened. And together you get this kind of like wide sounding 808 effect. The split allows you to do it without phasing your bass weird. It kind of comes from like the SoundCloud days. You know, I was really influenced by Glory Day SoundCloud stuff. You know, that's this 808 widening thing is kind of a Sam Galatry thing. He used to always have really dope wide 808s. And I always like putting that type of influence into the projects I'm working on. Added this piano element here, just the chords, really simple. And I believe I use this contact library called the Maverick, yeah. And what I do anytime I use a piano VST is I'll double the speed and put it up the octave. And once you bounce that down to audio and stretch it back down, basically just halve the time, you get this sound. It's a lot more realistic. It sounds like a sample or something. More lo-fi, if you will. And that's basically the basis of the beat, is those elements there. And then I really don't bring a lot of elements in until we get to this broken down section. You know, I kind of just started playing with some spacey. I take these vocal samples and I'll put like tape delay on them and kind of mess with the time knob. And you get these kind of weird pitching effects. And these are really, really quiet in the background, you know, just to add the vibe.
I'm so spoiled.
And then I add one of my favorite things to add ever, and it's this Reese that I call low tiller bass that my homie Psychic Type made. It's really good for adding like drama to a section.
Just turn down your avenue. Yeah.
And you got this reverse transition, and
I just turn down your avenue. I had to. But I'm mad at you. You always say I got an attitude. Oh, oh, yeah. But that's you. You was acting rude. I had to ask you if you had a few.
You know, this is just one of those beats, man. It's like not really a lot going on. It just kind of serves its purpose. You know, it's just serves the song. It gives a lot of space to the artist, you know, to do her thing. And, you know, she had such a great top line that it just carries the song. But still, one of my favorite productions I've been involved in.
Just turn on your avenue. Yeah, you always say I got an attitude. I just turn on your avenue. I had to, but I'm mad at you.
Well, there you have it, guys. Avenue by H.E.R, one of my first real placements. Let me know in the comments if there's any other beat that I've been involved in where you'd like to see a breakdown, and I'll do my best to get it done. Peace.